Welcome to you all. Through the short video lecture, today we will discuss about the medium transmission lines, right? Hope in the past class we have discussed about the short transmission line, and now we will discuss about the medium transmission line. You can recollect that a short transmission line calculations, that is voltage transmission power at the relatively low voltage, that is less than 20 kilowatt, will be considered as low transmission. But now here in the medium transmission lines, the length is 50 to 150 kilometer and voltage potential is greater than 20 kilowatt. If these two conditions are satisfied, we can consider the transmission line as medium transmission line, and here the effects of the capacitance cannot be neglected. So earlier in the short transmission line, we have considered only the resistance and inductance, but here we must include the capacitive effect. But how we can include in a possible minimum complication way, we can do it, right? So that we will discuss here. Therefore, in order to obtain a reasonable accuracy in the medium transmission line, the line capacitance must be taken into consideration, right? And the capacitance, as we already know, that the capacitance is uniformly distributed over the entire line, but we could not consider as it is because it is a very, very tough to calculate, and that's why we will go for some moderation, that is such as treating the localizing the line capacitance gives a reasonable accuracy result. To get the reasonable accuracy means with some approximation we will consider the capacitance are localized, right? So localized means there is a possibility you can locate at the receiving end, or maybe at the sending end, or maybe mid of the two. So that based on that, you can classify the medium transmission line into three categories. One is end condenser method, another one is nominal T method, another one is nominal pi method. So end condenser method is nothing but, in this method, the capacitance are connected at the receiving end. So without considering the capacitance, this equivalent circuit is nothing but a short transmission equivalent circuit. But here Vs is the sending end, Is is the sending end current, R is the line resistance, XL is the line impedance, and C is the capacitance, and VR is the receiving end voltage, IR is the receiving end current, IC is the charging current, right? Charging current of the line capacitance. And these things already explained here. So now you can take a phasor diagram. So for example, to make the phasor diagram, I need to go for an whiteboard, right? So your VR receiving end voltage starts from the receiving end voltage. VR is the reference vector VR, and then you know the receiving end current IR, which you can measure, and this IR, and angle between these two you can consider as phi R, that is receiving end power factor, right? So now if you know these two things, and you can add the capacitance current, that is IC is the capacitance current, on a vertical manner. Here you need to draw in this way, so you move to this particular end, or can I erase, so you can imagine your IC, the capacitive current IC, and this current you can mark it as IS, sending end current, right? So now the sending end current flows through a resistance, and here you can draw, this is VR, and this is your IS into R, and with respect to the impedance, it is 90 degree with respect to this current, IS current, and voltage component IS into XL, IS into XL. And now these two things connecting these two points is nothing but IS into Z, impedance, line impedance Z. And now when you connect these two points, this is nothing but receiving end voltage VS, right? So now this is the phasor diagram. For the same phasor diagram, you can write the expression also, right? Since we have considered the receiving end voltage as reference, your VR vector is equal to VR plus J0, and load current as IR is equal to IR into cos pi R minus J sin pi R. It is a basic current expression, and capacitive current IC is equal to, as per your expressions, J into VR into omega C, or J into this omega can be written as 2 pi F C into VR. Now the sending end current IS is equal to, from the picture itself you can understand, IS is equal to IR plus IC. So the same thing, IR plus IC, IR you can write as it is, and this IC you can write. So you just elaborate those things, IR multiplied with cos pi R plus J into minus of IR, this minus taken into inside, minus IR into sin pi R plus J is taken as common plus 2 pi FC VR. So this is the imaginary part. Now your IS into Z, this total thing you can write it as IS into Z. IS is equal to R plus JXL, right? So now sending end voltage VS is equal to VR plus IS Z, and this based on the your phasor diagram IS, which one, VS is equal to VR plus IS into Z. So you can see here VS is equal to VR, this phasor, plus this phasor, IS into Z, and that you can write here, VR plus, that you can elaborate also, VR plus IZ into R plus JXL, right? Thus the magnitude of this sending end voltage VS can be calculated. And now the percentage of voltage regulation is nothing but sending end voltage minus of receiving end voltage divided by receiving end voltage multiplied by 100. Percentage of transmission efficiency is nothing but output power delivered divided by output power delivered plus losses. So here your VR, IR, cos pi R is the power delivered, that is receiving end voltage, receiving end current, or receiving end power factor. And same thing you can put here, plus IS squared into R, that is power loss. That loss is nothing but based on the circuit diagram, IS squared into R is nothing but loss component, which is nothing but heat loss component, or I squared R loss component, and this can be marked as IS squared into R. So now these are the expressions, and this is nothing but, and this is the IS expression. IS into Z is the voltage drop expression, right? So here you can write it as voltage drop. And what are the limitations of this approximation? That means actually the capacitance is a uniformly distributed capacitance. We are considering as a lumped element, and that too the lumped element at the which end, you can see here at the receiving end. So with this assumption, what are the limitations? Here there is a considerable error in the calculation because the distributed capacitance has been assumed to be lumped and concentrated. Because lumped na consider pannadanaala there is some error, and this method overestimates the effect of line capacitance. Overestimates the effects of line capacitance, right? So the next method is nominal T method, and here your total capacitance of the line, that is lumped element, is considered at the midpoint of the transmission line. That means suppose if it is a 100 kilometer transmission line, on the 15th kilometer there is a capacitance. In such a way, we are assuming an half of the total resistance is lumped on the sending end side and half of the resistance on the receiving end side. So, such a way, this was rearranged. The same circuit R by 2 is rearranged this side, X by L, XL by 2 is also rearranged, right? Now, this is the equivalent circuit for the nominal T method. You can imagine this is the T symbol. Now, we are introducing one more voltage parameter here. Sending and receiving, sending and current, everything is we already familiar. And this I up to this level is IS. And now, this is the charging current. The voltage across this you can consider as V1. And in this side is once again the same terminology, receiving end voltage and receiving end current, right? So here also you can draw a phasor diagram. So hope you can start here. The first line is reference line VR, and the IR is the next line, and IC you can draw this particular current of current with reference to the voltage, which is a leading component. And IC current, and you will get an IS, and this IS we are going to consider and hereafter, right? And here one thing is current flowing through this part of component is IR and this part of component is IS, and that's why here IR into R by 2 and this much amount of voltage drop on the across the resistance on the receiving end side. Similarly, this is IR with respect to this IR only. Right? These two lines are parallel. This IR and this IR R2 are parallel because this is a unity power factor current. And this is the IR into Z by 2. Since because of the impedance, IR into XL by 2 is another reactance. Now this part is IR into Z by 2. Now you will get the potential of V1. And again, there is another resistive drop because of the IS current into R by 2 and IS reactive drop IS into XL by 2, and you will get IS Z by 2, and totally you will get VS. For this you need to write the expression, and remaining things are almost same. Voltage across C, V1 is equivalent to VR plus that is VR plus IR into Z by 2 is nothing but V1. So this expression VR plus IR Z by 2 is nothing but V1. So this triangle, right? And for that you can elaborate the expressions. In capacitive current, the same expression J into 2 pi FC into V1. Sending end current I, the same expressions. And sending end voltage VS is equal to V1 plus IS into Z by 2. This triangle alone, VS, V1 and IS Z by 2. These three alone involved. And you can write this expression, right? So with this you can understand the nominal T method, right? The next is the nominal pi method. And nominal, if you know the VS and if you know the VS and VR, you can write write the expression of VS minus VR divided by VR is the voltage regulation, and also you can write VR VR IR cos pi R is nothing but a receiving end power factor, and with that you can add the resistive drops and you will get the nominal T method calculations, right? So hope this we can stop here. Since it is only a 15 minutes recordable video, I will continue in the nominal pi method. I will continue in the next video. Thanks for watching. Thank you.